Yeah, that's why. Okay, come. Now we must be serious mode.
Okay.
Right? 18.1. Okay. I'm going to read the question as usual. Raise your hand, okay? Shh. Alright. No more talking. Okay, enough. You already sing a lot of songs to me. That's too noisy again, okay? Now, page 457, if you do not know what I'm talking about, page 457. Now, I did until question 6 with you, right? If I'm not wrong, I did 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, right? Am I right to say that?
Yeah.
Then question 8, I also did the directly proportional one.
Yeah.
Agree enough? Okay? Question 8, A and B, I complete it. I just want to find out.
Yes.
Okay, so I'll be starting with question 9. Yeah? Just me. Question 9. Any problems? Twelve, thirteen, 14, 16, 17, 20. Absentee is 20. 20A lah, huh? 22.
This is terrible.
That's all lah for 18.1. I do 18.1 first lah. Huh? Okay, not so stressed lah. Let's look at 28. Find each of the following. This is 28. Now, class, what is the first thing that comes to your mind when you see this? Don't do right.
Please.
Read. Do you think sleeping is a good idea?
You bring it up.
Straight away, what do you think you should bring?
You bring your water.
Okay. What you should do actually. Okay. Now, there's no way. Anybody okay? Can or not? okay? Because for integration, you must remember, there's no product rule, there's no quotient rule. Yes. I take a look first.
Minus.
My mistake, thank you. So is this one right? Yes or no? dy dx is this guy. Everybody okay here? I'm talking to you. Are you okay?
Yes.
Okay. From dy dx, how do I get y?
Integrate.
Okay. So y will be integrating this.
Put your
friends
here.
Are you okay?
For long time.
Alright, so integrate.
Very long time. Yeah.
X square over 3. Hey, rubbish. X square over 2. Then, X 4 over 12, right? 3 times 4. Minus 5 over 3 X plus D. Now, won't you see again? Because C is taken just now. You can use D, you can use other letter. But plus, I want to warn you to try not to use E. Because E is the long, that kind of E. 2.7 something something. You try not to use E, okay? Plus D. Alright, now, how do I get the D? The curve passes through this point, correct? 1, 4. Sub in X1 and Y, 4. Okay, because they say at the point 1, 4. So, when X is 1, Y is 4. So I'll have 4 equals to 1 over 2 minus 1 over 12 minus 5 over 3 plus D. So D is 4 minus half plus 1 over 12 plus 5 over 2. So what's this answer?
21 over 4.
Is this 21 over 4?
Yes.
Yes. So this is
21
over 4.
Rewrite.
So yes, then rewrite it. What they say? Is it for the equation of curve? So equation of curve. Will be y equals to x squared over 2 minus x4 over 12 minus 5 over 3x plus 21 over 4. Now, can you see that this is actually not difficult, but you have to integrate twice as well. Okay, and what's the problem here? Students will forget that they must find out c. Everybody here? So that is your 18.1. Are you all okay? Can, huh? Okay, now. Then we move on to 18.2. Okay, wait for a while. Okay. 18.2, yesterday I did 1A for you, right?
Comment?
I did some questions for you.
Yeah.
I did 1A, 1F, 2B, 2C. I stopped where? Did I do 4A? Or I did answer 3B?
Did I answer 3B?
I did answer 3B, la, correct? Okay, so I'm going to read, don't talk already, alright? 4A, 5A. What's wrong with you, Tommy?
Because you sit on.
You know, huh? You cannot get the answer. That means you are careless, that's all. That's all I can tell you.
Amen, God, I have to go.
Amen, God, what? Then I'm what? Empress Tower. 4A, 5A, 6C, 7B, 10.
I'm 10,
okay? 14? Okay, good. That's what I expected. If you 14 is a bit not traditional, understand? The question is not very traditional, but this is the higher order of thinking. Yo. Who's very noisy?
Isha.
It's always noisy, what, since last year? Hey. No, that's not your life, mate.
Since
Sec 1. Oh, since Sec 1 now. How many of you are with him since Sec 1? Oh, poor thing.
Okay. I know, right?
Poor thing. Isha, so you have been noise polluting them since Sec 1?
Oh, yeah, great.
Enjoy.
How many trees have you have X. Okay, because the expression is the same.
Yeah, yeah, we know.
Then you integrate your right to X. Now, when you integrate from 0 to 3,
yes,
it's the same as when you integrate from 1.
3
to 8. Then the answer is what? No, I'm not saying the obvious. You must understand the whole thing.
Yeah.
Okay, now let's take a look at what. And how dare you laugh at me? Okay? How you think so much? Let's don't understand the only part. Don't explain, I tell you.
M3 minus M0.
1. 0 to 8. Mx, dx. Now, do you agree that if I remember yesterday when I start, you have to be sorry, after you go, I change the area under the graph. Now, 0 to 8, I can find it by 0 to 3, then from 3 to 8, right? The graph will be, the area will be the same. Do you all agree? So, this is equivalent to 0 to 3, fx, dx, plus what? 3 to 8. Fx, dx, right?
Yes.
Sure. So what is this? 12 plus 12. Answer? 24.
What?
Yes. Do you understand what I'm talking about here?
Sure, sure.
Okay? Do you understand how I get 24?
The weight plus this area under graph.
Oh, you see, let me just hang on to the graph, okay? Let's say the graph like that. Yeah. Okay? Now, from 0 to 3,
so when you see
this area is 12. Yeah. From 3 to 8, this area is also 12. Yeah. So how do I get from 0 to 8? Don't you agree I add this two area up?
Oh my
so
God.
It's the same thing. Understand what I'm saying? Okay? Alright, now, next. Then now, it's part 2. This one. Actually, when you set this up question, right, not all the expect you to get correct. Right? It's the part 2, part 3 that I expect you to get wrong. But some people, when they see this freak out, don't know how to do it. Okay, yeah. Alright, so let's look at one. 3, 8, 1 plus 2 fx dx. Okay. Let's take a look at this. Now, do you agree that this is the same as integrate from 3 to 8, 1 dx? You can split right, remember? Plus what? Integrate from what? 3 to 8, 2 fx dx, right? Remember I said you can integrate individually, whether it's plus or minus. Okay, now don't integrate first. I want to show you something first. 3, 8, 1 dx plus. Now, the 2 can bring out, right? Constant can bring out, I'll say it's also okay. So, 2, 3, 8 fx dx, again. Okay, now, this one we don't know, but we can integrate. How to integrate 1?
X.
X. So the first one becomes X, 3 to 8, right? Plus 2 times of 12, correct? Because I saw already give you. Okay? So this one becomes 8 minus 3 plus 24. 5 plus 24. Answer? 39.
What do you mean minus 3?
X. First one is X, then you must minus the second one. Okay, hey, you all remember the definite integral now?
Yes.
You must sub in and you minus. You know, after that, you get everything. Huh? Okay? So is this okay?
Yes.
Part 3 now.
That's how they learn.
Part 3, yeah? Integrate from 3 to 8, 2fx dx plus 1. Now, a lot of people will be confused. They will think that part 2 is the same as part 3. You think it's the same?
Yes.
What do you mean by this? Only instead of that, you plus 1. You understand? It's not inside. You must be carefully. You know? I will say, you're same. Just anyhow, right? Now. So like that, now 4D, the number mixed up also cannot get right one. Or, you know the iPad, you know the 4D, the computation one. Oh, cannot anyhow say, yeah. Okay? Now, so this one means you integrate 3, 8, 2, fx, dx. Then you plus a 1, right? So this is what? 2 times 12 plus 1. So, 24 plus 1, answer? 5. Yes. Everyone okay until here?
Yes.
Yes, good. It's the last part, right? Very last part, right? Some big question, never be popular, that's why no more. That means your mouth also no sound. Okay. Are you all okay so far?
Yeah.
Last question. Find also the value of the constant n for each value. Integrate 3 to 8. Fx minus fx. X is equal to what?
0.
Okay. Ah, very good. I got the correct thing. Speed, right? This one means integrate what? 3 to 8 fx dx minus integrate 3 to 8. Now, m is a constant, right? They say, you look at the question, did they say m is a constant? Yes, constant means it's a number. M can bring up, right? Then x dx equals to 0, agree? Yes or no? So, this one we already know. How much is this guy here? 12 minus m, right? How do you integrate x? X squared over 2, 8, 3 equals to 0, right? Love it?
Yeah.
Okay, now we are going to do it. 12 minus m, I will have 8 squared over 2 minus 3 squared over 2 equals to 0. 12 minus m, so it's 64 over 2, which is 32, right? Minus 9 over 2, which is what? 4.5 equals to 0. So negative m into, okay, you minus this one. This one, what's this? What's 32 minus 4.5?
27.5.
My heart is 7. It's equal to minus 12, right? Correct now. So the minus will be gone, right? See, so what's m? 12 divided by 27.5.
Give me a fraction, what's the answer?
24 out of 55. Can you all see? Can you all see? Now, do you agree that this one looks like quite difficult, but actually it's quite easy? Okay, you just must know the techniques of it, that's all. Understand? And sometimes, O level, they like to put like maybe 3x lah, 5x lah, then you must know you can pick up. Okay, so once you're exposed to this kind of questions, actually there's no problem in doing this kind of question at all. Okay, everybody clear? Everybody clear? Okay. Now, later on, okay, can you give your 18.1 and 18.2 to Sui? I give you rubber bands. Then you just dump it in my tray, okay? And the people please help her, we'll make her do all the work. Okay, those who cannot have it today, right, later by tomorrow. Is that clear? Okay. Now, I want to just introduce the trigo one first. Because this class is very scared of people, I cannot start tomorrow, and then after that you cannot settle down. Okay. The first thing is this. I never go and memorize the integration one. I just make sure I memorize the differentiation one. Then you will switch the thing, that's all. Okay? Now, let me show you. Are we okay? Go ahead and first start. You still first start. Make sure they're ready now. Go make people to professor, okay? When I differentiate cosine, I get negative sine. When I differentiate tangent, I get secant. Okay. Okay. So that means when I differentiate this, I get this. That means when I integrate this, I'll get this one.
Yes.
So when I integrate cosine x, what do I get?
Sine x.
Sine x plus c. What about integrate sine x? Negative cosine x plus c. You see? You understand when you integrate this, it becomes cosine x.
No, but the minus should be in the sine, but not negative.
No, you want sine, you don't want minus sine. You want the sine to throw, the negative to throw over. So what if you integrate secant square x?
Oh, tangent.
Become tangent x plus c. So that's how you get your page 466, autumn to 466.
Wait, but the sign one very confusing.
No, the sign one is not confusing. It just means that when you integrate this one, you bring the this one minus, no? Minus, you integrate this, it's minus the sign one.
We can't integrate minus sign x.
No, you can only integrate sign x. Correct now, you integrate minus sign x for what? Okay? Can the minus, you bring all the negative one, right? It's a constant now. Correct? So, when you integrate cosine is sine, integrate sine is minus cosine, and integrate secant is secant square is tangent x. Everybody okay? Now, plus, I do not think you should go and memorize this, okay? You just need to memorize this and then just reverse. Okay? Must need to remember the c. But the c only comes in when it's indefinite. Sine, cosine, tangent also got definite. Whereby this is like pi over 4, pi over 2, that kind of thing. That's what I'm talking about. So it's the same thing, alright? Okay, come. Let's take a look at example 13. I'm going to give a few examples, okay? Alright, so are you okay here? Alright, Now, plus, you know what? This one is not even in the conference.
Right,
everything. You can write yourself up. Okay? I will always write this one down first. Then this one I won't write one because it's just because it's quite easy. Indefinite, this is a?
Definite.
So?
So there's no C.
Correct, I know there's no C. C is not the issue. It's 2x. When you integrate sine, what do you get?
Minus
sine x. Then pi over 2 is 0, right?
Yes.
Okay, now, excuse me. Cosine curve is like this. Huh? This is 0,
yeah,
this is pi over 2, this is?
But it's minus now, it's minus cosine.
It's pi, right? Go on first. This is what? 3 pi over 2, what is this?
2 pi.
Pi, right? What is this? 1, right?
1.
This is?
Minus 1.
Negative 1. Okay, shit. Don't worry, method, you'll come to that. This is 2 times pi over 2 minus cosine pi over 2 minus 2 into 0, right? Minus cosine 0. Nobody is to tell me cosine 0 is 0. It's not algebra, you understand?
It's not algebra.
Okay. Now, this one. Pi minus now. Cosine pi over 2. Cosine is what? 0, right? So this one is 0, agree?
Yes.
This one is pi minus 0, right? The first blank.
Pi.
Then this one is 0. What is this? Cosine 0. What is this? 1. So this answer is pi plus 1, right?
Yes.
Wow. Can you see that the answer is pi plus 1?
Yes.
Okay, you will ask me, Jer, must I give it to 3-centric or can it be in pi plus 1? You can leave it in pi plus 1, you can also leave it in 2-centric. It doesn't matter, because pi is a special number, it's fine. Just like e, e plus 1 also can, doesn't matter. Because e is a special number. Everybody okay? Can understand this? Can, huh? So please, what I'm worried about this class is this. When you see 0, right, the whole expression becomes 0. It's not true. If it's ex, when x is 0, it's 1. No, everything is 0, understand, huh? Okay, what's 5 power of 0?
1.
Let's go to the Kira 5 versus 0. Everything is 0, 0. No? The answer is not also 0. Alright? Okay. Hey, don't laugh at me. Pi is the truth.
Yeah, it's 2 0. It's 100.
2 Yala, you clever.
Plus
1.
Plus
1. Going the book, right? Going just like a song, huh? 4 plus 1 is 11. That kind of thing. Yeah, that's why you must have one. Let me just go one mark for the first question, 0 for the second question, and 0 for the third question. You get under radio?
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
So what is 0 for the power of 0?
Ah, good question. A lot of people are arguing. To me, it's 1. But a lot of people argue with me that it's 0.
It's 1
teacher,
0.
And I told them, you don't have to talk to me. I say it's 1. When you go higher level, the university will tell you. No, of course they'll tell you it's error. University no error, just
find it.
Everything is defined.
I also never say that, huh?
I'm fine.
Okay. Excuse me, this is the important one, and after this example, I'm going to stop. Is there any way I can integrate tangent?
You lost tangent.
No, but do you know that 1 plus tangent squared x is secant squared x.
Oh shit,
okay. The identity.
Wow.
Okay. So,
this is formula list.
Yes, this is in the formula list, yes. So what's tangent squared x?
Secant
squared x minus 1. The x, right? So it becomes what?
Tangent.
Tangent x minus x plus c.
Yes.
Understand what I'm talking about? Okay? So that's why the three identities come in again. That is very difficult. You understand? Now why do I want to say this today and not tomorrow? Because I want you to settle with this one first. Your brain needs time to settle this. Then tomorrow you can be tomorrow.
Yes.
You understand?
Your mom forgot.
And your class always needs a break from the whole thing when it's come to people. Then tomorrow, after you rest already, right, tomorrow can accelerate. If not, I will decelerate tomorrow. Understand what I'm saying?
See, you
okay. I never decelerate, but your brain decelerate. I didn't say I decelerate, I'll go at constant speed.
See, you see, I'll go at
okay, alright, huh?
You're
I know, but what for the heck? You understand, Ken, really? You don't have to say that. I don't care about the pace, as long as you finish on time, that's it. Okay? Then what are you doing? Want to join the challenge?